Go ahead.
Okay, dear Chairman of the Committee Board, dear members, dear guests, let me introduce my report with topic Lecture-Student Interaction in Distance Learning, a Case Study on Engineering Graphic Practicals. Distance learning is a special type of training designed to overcome special and temporary constraints. To this end, a virtual learning environment is creating through specialized software. Lack of face-to-face dialogue remains a major feature of this approach. Interaction between the participant in the learning process is considered as a key element in distance learning. Truly effective communication must be interactive. In particular, the lecture-student communication is aimed at interactive dialogue and inquiries, guidance, and instruction from the lecture. There are two main types of distance learning, asynchronous and synchronous. Research showed that the asynchronous teaching meeting methods don't create conditions for dialogue between the student and the lecture. Therefore, students trained through synchronous distance learning better master the material studied. Zoom, the following platform as used during the lecture process in our university. Zoom is a video conference platform apart from the standard features, no learning specific functionality and is offered. Microsoft Teams for Education is a special distance learning platform that creates virtual classroom with the necessary tools for conducting managing and learning process. Moodle is a learning management system and includes the necessary functionality for conducting distance learning. An important feature is the ability to expand the functionality through additional modules. Should be mentioned there the big black button module, which allows the creation of online classroom via video conferencing. Chronology of the lecture students' interaction. Each student receives an individual assignment for conducting a laboratory exercise. During the face-to-face training, the lecturer controls the implementation of the assignment and gives experimentation or makes adjustments in the student's work. For effective distance learning, the lecturer must also guide the students' work within the constraints in place imposed by the functionality of the applied platform. Generally, this is done in two ways, depending on the weather of the task, a complementary manual or a CAD system utilized. Figure one illustrates the sequence of the process in interaction when document is developed by hand. To get instructions, students must scan the document and send it to the lecturer. The lecturer could give verbal instruction or make virtual correction in the documents. It should be noted that LMS systems don't usually provide image editing tools. That means that the lecturer has to use an external graphics editor, which involves a large number of technical manipulation that take the considerable time. When working with the CAD system, the interaction takes place according to figure two. Here is an opportunity for the students to share the screen of his computer with the lecturer. The lecturer gives verbal instruction or makes a determination via remote control or share the screen of his own computer. The described chronology of interaction creates a number of limitations on the effectiveness of the learning process. The initiative of communication comes from the student. The students submit a request for communication only if in his opinion there are problems. It is possible to solve the task incorrectly without the slightest doubt about it. Distance learning is conducted by video conference, which involves synchronous learning, but in the principle, the student's activity and control by the lecture are shifted over time. The magnitude of the shift is determined mainly by the student and can reach a value that doesn't allow the lecturer to make adjustments to his work. This is just for me. When we work with our students, we use AutoCAD, CADstar, or SolidWorks. For the engineering graphics, sometimes we use AutoCAD or use Inventor 2. The main limitation for distance learning in engineering graphics are the results for applying only the standard functionality of LMS. The communication initiative is given to the students. Limited prospect of the lecture to motivate the student. Time shift between the student's activity and the lecture control. Communication is committed with a large amount of the technical work with receive the effectiveness of the learning process. Yes, we use for our practicals learning AutoCAD, SolidWorks, and Inventor. Yes.
Thank you, Desi.
Interaction. Just a moment. Interaction lecture students. In real time, we need to create specialized tools. Remote presence usually means a video conference where all participants have their camera and microphone on. For conclusively, when the learning process involves verbal discussion of the case and the case studied, the above approach is undoubtedly useful. The training in the engineering graphic is a reality to the preparation of graphic and textual documents, and the presence of the video connection doesn't give additional opportunity for the lecturer to monitor the work of students. In principle, it is possible to students to exhibit their documents through the video camera, but the quality is usually low and doesn't allow a useful analysis of the work. In order to encourage the efficiency of the learning process in distance learning in engineering graphics, it is necessary to develop deductive tools for document sharing, which allow the lecturer to monitor and guide the student's work. The modern development of internet technologies makes it relatively easy to create a specialized tool with the necessary functionality. For better organization of the activities related to the learning process, it is good to integrate this tool with LMS. This can be done into the figure 3. As an additional module, as an external tool. The implementation to the special tool as an additional module practically makes it part on the LMS system. Implementation as an external tool is the easier element, alternative. In this case, it's possible to use already available software that offers the necessary functionality. The condition
a 9-minute warning reminder, 9 minutes reminder.
Okay. The condition in the LMS is in model in accordance with the LTA specification, which allows both automatically identification of the students and recording the guide in the LMS. I can change the the block diagram for the created deductive tool along a real-time interaction is shown in the figure 4. The students opens from the HTTP server a page which are additional to the template text or graphics and constrains the necessary software for the task. The interaction lecture student is carried out as follows. The student platform the task in the HTML documents using the built-in in the documents functionality. Each minimum self-identified part for the information edited by the students is a more automatically sent to the HTML server and saved in the database. The lecturer has an access to the information in the database, which allows him to monitor in real time the progress of the development of the each student's solution. The coding of the information is done by means of a asynchronic XHR request, which work in the background and it is invisible to the students. Students are warned in advance that everything they enter in the HTML documents is saved automatically. In my computer, I use the same program system, AutoCAD, KStar, and SolidWorks. We have a students version for this program, and our students use them. Figure 5 shows the HTML page identity for the lecture. It contains a list of all students who attended the practicals. When the lecture indicates a student's name, he reserved his work in the current state in which is it on the student's computer screen. If it is necessary to give instruction to make adjustments, he used one of the communication channel provided by the LMS. And conclusions, the main advantage of the distance learning is the ability to conduct classes in the emergency construction conditions. Major disadvantage for both students and the lecturer is the lack of direct contact in communication complicates the creative process. When the number of students is large, it is harder for the lecturer to monitor each of them and give individual advice and guidance. Condition practical classes in engineering graphics is associated with specialized problems. When developing paper documents, they usually take pictures with their mobile phones. In many cases, the result is poor quality, which makes it difficult for the lecturer to analyze their making corrections. Requires adjustable software products. As a result, this process is required, difficult, and incurious. The analysis made in the present work showed that in order to reduce these shortcomings, it is necessary to develop the deteriorate tools that address the specific task and provide interaction lecture students in real time. The developed deteriorate tools was tested during the distance learning. The results show greater motivation and better students' results. Thanks for your attention.